Just before the recent House election in October, Prime Minister Shinzo Abe pledged to make public daycare services and kindergartens free for children between the ages of 3 and 5 and free for children below the age of 3 if they were from low income households. It was an obvious point to win odds, and Abe offered few details as to how the government would pay for such a policy.All he said was that a good portion of the projected consumption tax fee would be diverted into social services, one of which would be free preschool care. Whether the gambit was instrumental in securing victory for the ruling party is hard to tell, but in any case after the election was over the chickens came home to roost.The most persistent problem with regards to daycare in Japan is not the cost but rather the early. Many children living in cities are on waiting lists, and as a result some go to unsolicited daycare centers. Such centers are private facilities that have not been certified by the proper authorities and thus can't be considered public daycare.Which requires things like minimum interior floor area and employees with credentials. Many parents were angry because at first the government said that unsolicited daycare facilities would not fit for the proposed free daycare program. In that case, these parents said, the program was unfair, because until the government can guarantee enough public daycare slots for every household that needs them,IT was wrong to peg the parents WHO had to resort to unsolicited private daycare in order to fulfill their employment responsibilities. Consequently, the government is now saying IT will also subsidize the fees up to a certain level for unsolicited daycare, so we don't know at this point what type of daycare services will be co-led. Unsolicited daycare, as IT stands,include a large range of services, and not just a pensy private kindergartens and baby-sitting services run out of someone's home. IT also include company in-house daycare services, after-hours child care services and so-called baby hots. The Abe administration maintains that IT will provide enough slots in public daycare facilities by 2020.According to an article in the NOB 18 Tokyo Shimbun, the government estimates that 32 万 slots will be needed by that time are an estimate based on the number of applications for slots in recent years and the percentage of married women between the ages of 25 and 44 WHO are working. However,リサーチシンクタンク野村リサーチインスティチュートエスティマツザット88万6千スロッツウィルビーニーデッド、フィッチーズオールモースト3タイムズアズメニー。イフノムラスカクアションズアークローサートゥーザトゥルース、ゼンザゴエルンメント、イフ IT スティックストゥーイッツワード、クッドビーサブサイディジングプライベートデイケアフォーロンガーザン IT アペアレンティーリンテンズ。アンドシンスプライベートデイケアイズウスアイモアエペンシーザンパブリックデイケアIT could end up being quite a pensy for taxpayers. As IT stands, many parents WHO send their children to private daycare facilities can receive a subsidize from their local government's house I up to half the cost. But like all social services that depends on the income of the parents.